Today our topic is thermal resistance of cylindrical valve. In this video, we will see how to calculate the thermal resistance for a cylindrical valve. So this is a figure of hollow cylinder where L is the length of the cylinder, R1 is the inner radius, R2 is the outer radius, and T1 is the temperature of inner surface, and T2 is the temperature of outer surface, and K is the thermal conductivity of the material, and here A equal to surface area of the cylinder. Here we should take surface area only, because the heat is flowing through surface, not through the cross sectional area. So that is why we should not take the cross sectional area. We should take the surface area of the cylinder, that is area which is perpendicular to the direction of heat flow. So surface area of the cylinder is 2 pi RL. This R is at some radial distance, and Q is the rate of heat transfer, and dT by TR is temperature gradient. From Fourier law we can write Q equal to minus KA dT by DR. Substitute the value of the A. What is the value of A? 2 pi RL. So here we should substitute 2 pi RL. Here we know that K is constant, that is for material, and Q is constant for steady state. So by rearranging the equation, and here variable is R. So we will integrate this 1 by R, and limits are from R1 to limits are from R1 to R2 and T1 to T2. So an integration of 1 by R is what? Ln R. And integration of dt is T. By substituting the limits, we will get Q by 2 pi L into ln R2 minus ln R1 equal to K into T1 minus T2. So once again, by rearranging, Q equal to 2 pi L K T1 minus T2 by ln R2 minus ln R1. We know that ln A minus ln B is ln of A by B. So we can write ln R2 minus ln R1 as ln of R2 by R1. So by rearranging once again, Q equal to T1 minus T2 by 1 by 2 pi KL ln R2 by R1. By comparing with this electrical analogy, we will get RTH equal to 1 by 2 pi KL to ln R2 by R1. This is the thermal resistance for cylindrical valve. Thanks for watching this video.